Today we're going to talk about one-sided limits. So notice the new notation. We want to find the limit as x goes to 0 from the left, right, where it's smaller, of the absolute value of x over 4x, and the limit as x goes to 0 from the right of the absolute value of x over 4x. Okay? So how do we start? Giving us a hint, we have a little graph paper down there. Should I make a t-chart? So what numbers do we typically start with when we're trying to make a quick t-chart? We have some negatives, right? Some positives. Negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2. Everybody okay with that? Okay. So let's plug in negative 2. If we take the absolute value of a negative 2 and we divide it by 4 times a negative 2, we're going to get 2 over negative 8, which is, all right, so we've got negative 2, negative 1, 4. Now we need to do a negative 1, so the absolute value of a negative 1 over 4 times a negative 1 is going to be negative 1 fourth again. So at negative 1, we're at one negative 1 fourth. And what happens at 0? Undefined. Can't divide by 0. So asymptote or something, a whole something's going on there. Okay, now let's try and plug in 1, absolute value of 1 over 2, or 4 times 1 is going to get us, so at 1 we're at a 4th, and then when we plug in 2, the absolute value of 2 over 4 times 2 is going to get us 1 4th, suspicious that we're always 1 4th, right? What would happen if we plugged in 3? 1/4. If we plug in 4, 1/4. So we don't get to be 0, but to the right of 0, we're always going to be 1/4. And again, we don't get to be 0, but to the left of 0, we're going to be negative 1/4. So the limit as x goes to 0 from the left is going to be negative 1/4, but the limit as x goes to 0 from the right is going to be positive 1/4. So far so good? Questions on this one? Okay. So one more time, we'll iterate it once again. Distance of a limit, we've written this down before, but the limit only exists if both the left and the right limits exist and are equal to L. They have to be equal to the same number. So if a function, f is a function, and c and l are real numbers, then the limit as x goes to c of that function is going to be L, provided it's left and right behavior are doing the same thing. They're both approaching that same number L. Okay? So, here's another example. Find the limit of f of x as x approaches 2. If f of x is equal to, we've got a curly bracket here, x squared plus 1 when x is less than 2, and negative 1 half x plus 6 when x is greater than 2. So this is just a kind of a way of reading. Just think of inserting the word when. So it's establishing its domain, isn't it, for that particular portion of the function. Okay. we could plug in some numbers, or we could say, wait a minute, I have two separate equations here, right? And f of x is just a fancy way of saying y. So y equals x squared plus 1 when x is smaller than 2, less than 2, and y equals negative 1 half x plus 6 when x is greater than 2. That first equation is parabola, what's its vertex? 0, 1. So we have a parabola with a vertex of 0, 1, and it's opening and so it's only defined when x is smaller than 2. Not equal to 2, but smaller than 2. So if we moved one step to the right, 1 squared is 1, will be 1 up, and 1 to the left, 1 squared, negative 1 squared is also 1, right? What happens if we're 2 to the left? Up 4, original vertex. And we can't go 2 to the right, can we? 1, 2, 3, 4, we don't have an open circle there. But we can continue to go to the left. If we were 3 to the left, we would be 9 up. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more from there. And we have our left half of our piecewise function. Okay? Now what do we do from there? Now we have a second equation that says y equals negative 1 half x plus 6. What is that? Line, and it has a slope of negative 1 half and a y-intercept of 6. So this guy starts out at 6, but it can't be 6, can it? Y can't be 0, 6 because x can't be 0. So it would be here, and then it would go down 1 and to the right 2, right? But it can't be 2 because it has to be greater than 2, but we can go down 1 to the right 2, down 1 to the right 2, down 1 to the right 2, and keep going, can't we? So here is our second half of our piecewise function. Second equation of our piecewise function. So far so good? So, we want to evaluate the limit as f of x as x approaches 2. So, from the left-hand side, what's happening? It's approaching what number for y? 5. And from the right-hand side, it's approaching 5. So, we would say that the limit is... Overnight shipping, $9 for the first pound, 10 for the second, 11 for the third, and so forth. Show that the limit as x approaches 3 does not exist. So you're going to be graphing some of these things again, right, the step functions. So, if I want to use FedEx or whatever overnight shipping company it is, my flat rate for my first pound is $9. So in this case, they gave you these set of equations, right? But we should be able to generate that equation, right? So what's happening here is y is equal to 9 when x is between 0 and 1, not inclusive of the 0, but inclusive of the 1, right? And then y gets to be 10 when 1 is less than x is less than or equal to 2, and so forth. Okay, so So when we see y equals 9, that's what kind of a line? Horizontal. So we'll have a horizontal line. Doesn't cost anything to ship anything of 0 pounds, but the minute that you have 1/10 of a pound or whatever, right, 1/4 of a pound, so on, it's going to start costing you $9. And then what happens at 1? Still $9. Okay, but the minute it's more than 1 pound, then what happens? It's $10. So at 1 pound, it was still $9, but the minute it gets beyond 1 pound, now it's $10. And then what happens at 2? Yep. Anything above 2 or greater than 2 is going to charge us $11. Anything greater than 3 is going to be a $12 fee. And anything greater than 4 is going to be a $13 fee. So far, so good? So now that we have our graph drawn, we can show that as we approach 3, we're approaching 3 for x from the left-hand side, we're approaching 11 for y, but as we approach 3 from the right-hand side, we're approaching 12 for y, since these are two different l's, right? L is not the same, the limit does not exist. Questions on that one? Yep, limit does not exist because it's approaching 11 and 12 from the left and right sides. Okay? Okay. Well, what if they ask what's the limit as x approaches 2.5? 2.5 pounds would be approaching 11 from the left and 11 from the right, wouldn't it? Okay? Then you would say 11, right? But the minute it says something like 3, where it's doing two different things, right, from a left and right behavior, we say the limit doesn't exist for that particular number for x. Okay? So then you just say does not exist. It's approaching 11 from the left and 12 from the right. Okay. All right. Sound good? That's what we're doing today. Okay. Tables and graphs again. So, 10 problems, page 2, 833, section 12.2. And I know some of you are taking AP exam tomorrow, so video for tomorrow is posted on my website along with the notes, so you can catch up and or work ahead or what have you, and be ready to go.